اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. مدد يا أولياء الله عيننا بعوننا وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى بفضل الله. مدد سيدي السلطان يا سيد الشيخ عبد الوهاب الفائز الدغستاني، سلطان يا سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم عادل الحقاني، سلطان يا سيد الشيخ محمد عادل الرباني. رجال الله عينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى بفضل الله. لا أنت مقصودي ورضاك مطلوبي. We are upon a great season, alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granting us to reach these 10 days. And it is said by many ulama, wasta'idullah, wal-fajr. Allah is swearing by the fajr of Eid, or the fajr of Arafah, fajr of Eid, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal fajri wa layalin ashr, the 10 days, those many ulama say that these 10 days are now. It is said that these 10 days are the holiest 10 days of the year. They're a great season, and in them many pious servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala achieved to be near and dear to their Lord in these 10 days. So in Ahlillah, they say in this, when these seasons come, when we come upon an opportunity like this, where everything in it is magnified, multiplied endlessly, you find in Turuq, they give additional awrad, and the sheikhs are always asking the murids to do more. If you can fast these whole 10 days, alhamdulillah. If you can fast some of the 10 days, alhamdulillah. It is said if one fasts Friday, Saturday, Sunday in these 10 days, it's Allah grants him the reward of ibadah of 700 years. Now, ulama, some people would say, oh, this hadith are da'if. You can take da'if hadith in fada'il a'mal. To do more for Allah, you can. So, alhamdulillah, we have this. Again, we're alive. We have our minds. We have our health, for most of us. And we have our Allah granting us so many favors. We need to tahrir al-maqasid. This season is about tahrir al-maqasid. What is tahrir al-maqasid? Hajj, the whole Hajj ibadah is about purifying one's intentions. Because this Hajj, the Hajj season, the tawaf and the sa'i and all these activities, the Arabs before Islam used to do. They used to go and do tawaf around the house, the pagans. What's the difference between our doing and their doing? Is tahrir al-maqasid, is your intention. When you're going to Hajj, you are your intention. What is your qasd? Hajj linguistically means your aim. What is your aim? Your aim is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your aim is obedience to Him. And the maqasid have levels. Just like in fasting, we say there's the fasting of the awam and the fasting of the khawas and the khawas of the khawas. There's fasting levels. Some fast by just stopping eating and drinking. Some fast by stopping anything that displeases Allah. And some fast by not having in their heart other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's levels. Similarly with Hajj. Some go to visit the house of Allah. Some's maqsad is Allah. They're not going for the house, they're going for Rabbul Bayt, Allah. So their Hajj is different. But the whole occasion is our intentions are purified for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم صل على من انشقت الأسرار وانفلقت الأنوار وفيه ارتقت الحقائق وتنزل العلوم آدم فأعزز الخلائق وله تضاءلت الفهوم فلم يدركها صح. تفضل سيدي. بسم الله. We had announced that we have to do the program earlier. بسم الله. No, بسم الله. بسم الله. بسم الله. That way he can.
Stop.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. بسم الله. It's okay. مدد يا ولي الله علمنا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى الله وفضل الله. مدد سيد السلطانية. So we said, Sidi, before we start the zikr, we'd like to share some, let's sit with the permission of our Shaykh, and share something from what we've learned from them. Al-Hajj is about tahrir al-maqasid, purifying one's intentions. Because this sha'ira, this worship, even the pagans before Islam used to do. But the difference is, what's the difference? On the outwards, maybe they were making tawaf. And we Muslims make tawaf as well. The difference is what? Is your maqsad, is your intention, is your aim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna ad-deena 'inda Allah al-Islam, submission. Allah wants us to submit, to acknowledge our Lord, to worship Him purely, and to submit. That's why Allah, this is al-Eid al-Akbar. Eid al-Fitr is Eid al-Asghar. Eid al-Fitr, Eid al-Asghar, Eid al-Adha, Eid al-Akbar. Some ulama say that it is Eid al-Akbar because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala combines in it the obligation worship. In Ramadan, Allah is making this worship an obligation. We are mukallafin. We are responsible to obey. Hajj also, there's taklif in it. We are obliged to إقامة الأركان والشروط of Hajj, to establish, do according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us how to do the sha'ira. But there's an additional dimension to it. And this sha'ira is to remind us of what? To remind us of the story of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, and Sayyidina Ismail. إني أرى واستعيذ بالله إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك. الله سبحانه وتعالى telling us in Holy Quran that سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام was saying to his son, oh my son إسماعيل, لما بلغ معه السعي, when سيدنا إبراهيم became a young man, he said to him, I am seeing in the dream, in the vision, إني أرى, I'm seeing, although he saw it in his dream, but رؤيا الأنبياء حق. He said, I am seeing that I am sacrificing you. Means this is not a ru'ya, this is a haqiqa, this is a reality. I am seeing this reality happening. إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك، فانظر ماذا قال سيدنا إسماعيل. Say, Abati, فعل ما تؤمر. He didn't say, do according to what you see. He says, do as you were ordered. ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. You will find me, inshallah, from the patient ones. And ulama, why didn't Sayyidina Ismail say, ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا, patient, as Sayyidina Musa said? Because من الصابرين, this case, this, the affliction of human beings, the trials and tribulations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicts human beings, is for, until judgment day. So this is open to be من الصابرين for all the ummah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To be من الصابرين, ستجدني من الصابرين. So all of us are under trials. لِنَبْلُوَكُمْ. And all of us are invited to be either من الصابرين, to fulfill, to be patient with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's order, with Allah's affliction, and to submit, to surrender our will to His, to our Lord. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. When they both submitted, Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Ismail, both of them submitted. And Sayyidina Ibrahim put the knife. Full submission. But Allah is not doing this to torment Sayyidina Ibrahim with murdering or sacrificing his own son. No. Once they submitted inwardly, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took that affliction away. And this is a lesson for all of us. A lot of times people are squirming, are not happy with Allah's decree, are not accepting Allah's will and destiny for them, and they wonder why things keep getting harder, why the affliction is never lifted, why the troubles are never gone. Ulama said, from this story of Sayyidina Ibrahim, one must learn that as soon as you submit, that Allah lifts the affliction. Not only that, He lifts the affliction and then He sent a reward, sent a sacrifice. So there's much to learn in this season. But if anything, don't waste these 10 days. Don't let them go, come and go, as if nothing happened. There's al-baqiyat al-salihat, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Some ulama says 300 to 700. To 1,000, to 7,000 if you can do daily. Our Shaykh, Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad, also we shared some additional adhkar and awrad in the Naqshbandiya tariqah for murids to do. Fasting, fast if you can. At least the day of Arafah. If you can do more, do more. Charity, anything you can do. Allah is highlighting for us the aim. Inna ad-deena 'inda Allah al-Islam. For us, He's highlighting this occasion and making it Eid Akbar and showcasing the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ibrahim for us to learn. Hopefully, we're asking Allah, Ya Rabbi, grant us to be real Muslims. Real people who submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will and taqdeer. Not to object. Not to deny. Believers, when they're afflicted, they're between Allah's fadl and Allah's adl. There's hikmah. Even when He afflicts you with something, there's wisdom. And so we may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be real Muslim, real people of Taslim, and to reach inshallah to be real believers and real muhib of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In this day, on the day of Arafah, when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying to his ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this Hajj Farida, one of the Sahaba asked, every year? And Prophet kept quiet. Three times he asked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is it every year? And then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't ask. If I say yes, la wajabat. If Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said yes, then every year we'd have to go make Hajj. That's why ulama Ahl Sunnah, he has tasrif in Aqwan. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. That's why he used to avoid sometimes answering questions so that he does not burden his ummah more than it can carry. صَلَوَاتُ رَبِّي وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْهِ. We are all here because of the ni'mah of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَالنِّعْمَةُ الْعُظْمَى. صَلَوَاتُ رَبِّي وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْهِ. We are all here because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us to be from his ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to worship him in these 10 days to the best of our abilities and to do our utmost until the day of Arafah, until Eid. Inshallah, we have a program on the 8th next week. Next Friday, we rent a hall. Inshallah, we will gather iftar inshallah, and we have Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. We'll do some adhkar and ad'iyah. Wa min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-habib bi hurmati al-fatiha.